Welcome to the only Teemo guide you'll ever need, where me, your Iron 5 haven't played the game in 8 months player, introduces you to playing the objectively best champion, Teemo. But before I teach you how to play him, I will first need to teach you what this rat, I mean champion, does. To begin, his passive, Rat Warfare. Teemo transforms into a ward after not doing anything or standing in a bush for a short time. This can be used to escape or be used together with the second part of his passive, where he gets attack speed after leaving ward mode, to set up ambushes and kill his enemy. His Q, the Does Not Blind Blinding Darts, fires a blinding dart at his enemy, which does not blind but just makes the enemy's auto attack miss their target for a few seconds, except when their name is Kale for some reason. You max this first for optimal murder. His W, Move Quick, otherwise known as
the best ability in the game, boy!
As the name states, he moves quick. Press the ability to move even quicker. So quick that you can outrun someone without boots. It's so good that to not be too overpowered, you max this last. Teemo's basic attacks passively deal bonus magic damage and applies poison when a unit is struck. This has the bonus ability of tilting the player, even though sometimes it's pretty useless. Max this second, unless your muscle memory does it automatically, then max this first. His R, Noxious Trap. When unlocked, Teemo applies a global taunt on all enemy players and forces them to buy a red trinket. When the button is pressed, Teemo throws a shroom that explodes when an enemy steps on it. If an enemy is hit, deal magic damage and apply poison. Also, make it impossible for you to refund an item in the shop if it explodes on a champion after buying the wrong item accidentally. Why is this a thing, Riot? I don't want to buy a fucking rod! I wanted to buy a sword! Okay, so now that you understand what he does, where does he play? Most inferior people would say he should go top or support, but these people are wrong. As you see, he is a marksman. Where do marksmen belong? That's right, the bottom lane. Put him together with a meat shield, I mean Leona, and he is unbeatable. Except for when he is. Why would you play in bot lane? Well, as you remember what his Q does, you make auto attacks miss. And remember what the ADC does? That's right, auto attack. Now can you connect the dots? As for favorable matchups, I can confirm that Jhin is the best one, because you can deny his whole DPS. Actually, editor's note, this isn't true. The Jhin I was up against just sucked ass, and Jhin is a pain to deal with, so don't try to fight him. As for bad matchups, that will be AP Misfortune and AP Nasus. Not to forget Kale. Fuck Kale. Even though she isn't in your lane, why can't she just deny my Q for fuck's sake? Next, runes. For runes, I strongly recommend to just take whatever the fuck you want. Here are the ones I took. This one's called I'm out of breath from blowing, the Fuck it, I'll go lethality, and then the Fuck, I forgot to change back my lethality runes, and the build fucking sucked. Now, as you see, all Teemo's abilities scale off of AP, so the logical thing is to build attack speed. Your starters are your usual ADC items, so pick what you're more comfortable with. Then, first try to rush for Kraken Slayer to compensate for your low base AD, but also giving you a lot more attack speed that scales off how many items you have. Then, as second item, I use Borg to give myself more lane staying power and survivability in prolonged fights. Or, you go Nashor's Tooth to make yourself more useful for zoning with your shrooms and making your poison more of a hassle to deal with for the enemies. Either way, pick these two up. The order just depends on what you need more at the time. As your fourth item, you need Renounce Hurricane. If at this point the game isn't finished, then you need Renounce to boost your teamfighting usefulness. It boosts your teamfight usefulness by a lot and makes you even more annoying to the enemy team, making use of your global taunt on the players, making them tilt so hard they begin to play bad. Final item, I would go either Bloodthirster or Infinity Edge. Bloodthirster is for if you are dying more than you should, or are losing. Infinity Edge is to make you just a better murder machine in the late game if your team has the upper hand. But to create an upper hand in battle, you need to learn tactics. Okay, first, the important part. See these other lanes? While playing this best build, you play bot until you have their tower. Only then the other lanes come into play. It's, you know, like top, but with two people instead of one. Now that the important part is out of the way, let's talk fights. Playing ADC is about positioning in fights and dodging skill shots. Luckily, we have our Q to just say fuck you in particular to the enemy ADC and stand still in a fight while your meat shield tanks and CCs them.
That's extra irritant. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh no.
Oh.
That was ticket play, apparently.
You do this in every situation, so you don't even have to think about it. And if you ever are in the rare situation where you won't be able to kill them, just disengage and run away with the best skill in the game, his W. Run from Kale. Sometimes use your passive, but only just enough so the other Teemo mains still scream at you to use it more. Always queue the ADC. They are not there, just queue the mage, purely out of spite. Oh fuck, she's here again! Back in the enemy base, so you can make them panic and try to stop you. Somehow spill water on your keyboard in the middle of the game, making you AFK for 5 minutes. And last but not least, if the enemy is AP Misfortune and AP Nasus, just disconnect, because nowhere you're safe because of them. No, I'm not salty, just angry at myself for sucking so much. If you follow all of this to a T, then you too will lose 50% of your games, but still somehow get a mastery token. So, like, fun fact, I began on this video like 3 months ago, but then finals hit, as they do. And during those 3 months, somehow this build became like viable and gets memed a lot now by this one particular person in the Teemo main Reddit. So, like, people will probably think I'm like serious about it. This is a meme. Like, don't build this, it's awful. I have one good game, but that was mostly because the enemies just sucked ass. But thanks for watching.